Rising Tide, and it's an improvised piece with the fabric on the beach using the wind, the natural element. And I was thinking about the site that we were using and the fact that we're on the beach, and I was thinking about the issue of climate change and the fact that the tides will be rising and sea levels will be rising, and many communities around the world are threatened by that. And I thought that's a really visual way to use dance and movement and the natural elements outside.
Jane, and I am in my final year at Grace, studying contemporary art. This is my exhibition here today. It's all about our physical bodies and essentially begging the question, what part of us remains human? Is there any part that we can't replace with technology? So that's the kind of question behind the work at the moment. So you can see from the exhibition, it's all about different body parts and our relationship with technology, and I'm currently exploring uploading the mind and how essentially our brains are the only part of us that, you know, is that the only part of us that makes us human?
Helen Dunnerly.
Broad said, told me about the idea of an event on the sand, and I thought, oh, what if I got a crocodile on the sand? That'd be great. And I thought, I could half bury it in the sand and the wind would come across the texture of the back and make another shape. But then when we got here, I realised the sand is actually quite wet, and then there was water and there was still water, and then lo and behold, there's this beautiful curve in the sand, and the texture of the water over the sand is so similar to the back of the crocodile that that's where it is.
So my name is Alexka Kusowska, and I've got a performance piece which was inspired by the bunkers of World War II here on the beach. And the performance piece, it's about trauma and supporting people, and hopefully I'll be asking audience to help me carry those buckets of water in here and making marks on the beach for today.
Hi, I'm Dave Lothian, I live in Kimry, and I'm a hobby ceramicist, which means I make pots from time to time, but today I've made some fish, and they're brightly coloured fish, and they are representative of the challenges in the sea just now, particularly with plastic pollution.
Ceramic artist. I'm really excited to be here with Experimental Use of Space. I've brought with me some glaze tests, and I've been working with Rowan Flint. We've been printmaking, we've been raku firing and playing with our materials, and today is a great chance to explore some development of ideas for my ceramic utopian jungle.
I'm Rowan. This is a piece about healing. It's been an ongoing work for about 5 years, and so today I decided to build a den out of a deceased tree and some past works that I've made, and put them to bed and lay them to rest today in a peaceful spot on a beautiful beach.
Roderick Scott, I've made these boots and casts of shoes out of concrete, which I've then sealed and painted with acrylic paint. So this is actually meant to be an acrylic piece, and it asks the question, which direction now? At the moment, with all the chaos that we're suffering from, these boots are arranged in a way that no individual would be following the same path as another, and also the boots don't match in any way, either in whether they're left-handed or right-handed, or whether they're what colour they are. Part of the idea behind all of this is also that there is denial about everything that's going on, and so the boots are upside down, as if the heads of the people who are wearing them were embedded deep inside the sand.
Hi, I'm April Presley, and this piece was inspired by a song that I wrote many, many years ago, and I just fancied making something like an oasis in the desert to create a spiral, and there'll be a performance later.
I'm Margaret Preston. For a brief stage, I decided I wanted to revisit one of three sea songs I'd written a while ago. Both April Presley and I were interested in a linked installation and performance. We wanted to try theatre on the beach. This tale about a tragic mistimed romance has the basic elements of drama and of life that intrigue me. Encounter, chance, will. Choice.
Bonnie Davy went a wanted fish down by the deep blue sea, and on the stars he made a wish for a maid to lie with me. And as he lay and gazed a while, a wave his boat he rocked, an eerie song his mind amazed, a silky eye. And silvery, your hair of new spun gold. I've never seen your like before. Don't swim away in fear. Oh, come, my love, we meet to shore and marry me, my dear. If I come with you, my dear love, voice that makes me sing, Bonnie lad, I must refuse. My father, he is Neptune, my aim, the deep blue sea. Oh, come. Daily he was funny, and he was charming too. The slippery silver letter maid has lost her heart to you.
Oh, feather, can I leave you and go ashore wi' him? He has a twinkle in his eye, and he's tall and strong o' limb. My daughter, if ye go wi' him, ye ken ye'll nae come back. You'll lose your tail, you'll never swim. 'Tis a choice that you must make. The mermaid, she was lovesick, and to her love she swam. She lost her tail, her legs did kick, and ashore she gaily ran. A week she waited on the shore, she was mute, she tried to call. But Davy, he was out o' reach, did he not have had her back? No sweet and tender kiss, no love and arms entwined, so what would a dear maiden do? She died, did he love right?
My name's Moira Downey, and I've been inspired by installation, and I think this venue is an exciting opportunity to explore the environment round about and to work with the environment, the elements, the sea, the wind, the beach. And I was also aware that I wanted everything to disappear, because I was looking at taking an environmental line. I like making items in clay, an earthenware clay carryout, and put them in disposable bags. And my piece was watching these bags and clay disappear into the tide. And the title of my piece is called Ebb Tide.
Hello, my artist name is V2K. I'm from Aberdeen. Today I'm exhibiting a cutout called V2 Earth. It's just basically painted on a board and cut it out, just hands crossed, just like a sign language, which means like what's happening, Earth. So you kind of, I'm sending a question to Earth, you know, what's happening with you, how you doing, you know, let's have a nice day, you know, and stuff like that. So yeah, it's about that, because we're exhibiting on the beach. So.
Hi, I'm Lynn. I'm a hand weaver and trained scientist, and I make work that's looking at my family's connection ancestry to the weaving trade in northeast Scotland. So these two pieces of work are exploring the way that information gets transferred between generations in a family.
My name is Lynn Strachan, and the piece is called Reflection, and it's just a simple piece to get people to think about the beauty of the environment and how we can maybe improve it, or what effect we can have upon it.
Hi, I'm Rosie Wood, and this is the Beach Orrery, which is a model of the solar system to scale with a selection of littered planets. Here we have the Sun, which is not to scale. The Sun should really be 5 meters if it was to match the planets. And then you have Mercury, Venus, our own blue planet, the Earth, and Mars. So those are the little rock planets circling the Sun. And then you step out to Jupiter, with its well-known orange spot, the storm on Jupiter. And then you come out to Saturn, with its slightly wobbly rings. The amazing thing about Saturn's rings is they're only a meter thick out from his own, but they're ice crystals, so you can see them from a long way away. And then you come out to Uranus, which is a lovely blue gas planet, mainly methane. And finally, to Neptune, with its little storm on Neptune as well. Neptune is over 2.5 billion miles away. Uranus is 1.7 billion miles. And then you come into Saturn. Jupiter's about 0.5 billion miles. So you start to get a sense of space and scale. The universe, the solar system is massive. And what we've done for the first time here is track the orbits around in the sand. And earlier we had great fun walking the planets around their orbits. So that's the Beach Orrery. Thank you.
On va danser le long des galpes claires, à des reflets d'argent la mer, des reflets changeants sous la pluie. Ciel d'été confond ses blancs tons avec les anges si purs, la mer, bergère d'azur infinie. Voyez près des étangs.